So ini semua adalah hikmah-hikmah perkahwinan lah, menjauhi daripada perzinaan. Because we cannot deny, okay, semua humans ada desire, okay, ada desire, ada their own nafsu. Okay, and it's actually is in us lah untuk kita attracted to the opposite gender. Okay, so perkara ni akan berlaku, and it's up to us to actually handle it lah. And one of the way to actually make it into a halal thing is through pernikahan. Tapi pernikahan juga bukan saja about that, tetapi untuk a bigger purpose, which is ramaikan umat Islam, ada life partner yang dapat membantu kita untuk jadikan kita orang yang lebih baik, amalkan sunnah Rasulullah SAW, okay, and dapat menyambungkan nasab. So perkara-perkara ini semua kita kena ambil kira, and make sure kalau antum semua berkahwin, antum kena ada niat-niat ni tau. Antum jangan kahwin because of just for the sake of marrying someone, tapi you have to share the niat-niat yang baik dalam perkahwinan. This may sound like macam a marriage workshop or a marriage course, tapi this is something important to convey lah. Okay, Ana sendiri Ana belum kahwin, tapi when I belajar about kahwin ni, is an amanah yang berat, amanah yang berat. Okay, amanah yang berat, and for me, someone will be very very irresponsible kalau masuk dalam perkahwinan without the ilmu, without the ilmu, without knowing hak-hak suami, hak-hak isteri dan sebagainya, dan hak-hak sesama. So that is why nanti kita akan tengok part talak kan, bagaimana kes-kes talak sekarang ni is macam tengah skyrocketing tau, skyrocketing, and kebanyakan is from couples yang belum lagi 5 tahun kahwin pun. Okay, yang paling banyak bercerai unfortunately adalah couples yang belum sampai 5 tahun anniversary perkahwinan mereka, mereka dah bercerai. Kenapa? Okay, why is that the trend right now? Okay, because one of the thing I believe is because of the lack of knowledge, the lack of knowledge in marriage. Okay, the lack of knowing someone's punya responsibility, someone's punya right. So when you don't give someone's right, or you don't even know your own responsibility, then it's going to be hard to actually manage yourself. Then if you cannot manage yourself, apatah lagi you manage your life with someone else. All right.